Please enjoy hundreds of my video lectures on telecom and wireless. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Please also like my videos. Please share my channel with your friends and colleagues. Thank you.
Please look at this figure. The summary of all power control mechanisms is presented in this figure. All types of power controls work together to minimize power consumption at the mobile stations and also increase the overall capacity of the system transmit power. So this is depicted in this figure. The figure is self-explanatory and the reader is advised to examine this carefully. In this slide, let us look at some of the factors that are affecting power control performance. First one, mobile speed. This is due to the feedback being received after a delay. Why delays? Delay could be due to propagation, delay could be due to latency. Therefore, power control becomes less effective. The next one, power control errors. This is due to power control bits being received wrongly. If what was originally sent was a 1 and what is received is a 0, instead of power going up, the power will come down. What is the result? The required EB by I naught increases. The next factor is diversity. If diversity exists either in space or time, fading is reduced and this causes erratic power control. This is a bit of an irony. So we use diversity to counter fading, and if we use diversity and effectively reduce the fading, the power control goes haywire. The next factor is soft handoff. What happens during soft handoff? Please recall, when the mobile is in soft handoff, multiple base stations receive the same signal but independently detect a single power control command. That is, more or less two base stations work on power control bits simultaneously, and obviously the reliability of the power control bits on the downlink is degraded. Too many cooks spoiling the broth. Estimation of channel quality. If signal to noise ratio measurements themselves are inaccurate, power control will be less effective. The next one will be with respect to outer loop. Supposing the outer loop's step size is too small, the outer loop reduces error in the slow fading conditions but may not be able to adequately track fast fading. Smaller step size is good for slow fading but not good enough for fast fading, and vice versa. So these are some of the factors which continuously affect the power control's performance.
Hi guys, hope you have enjoyed this video. Before you leave this, please ensure that you are subscribing to this. Also, please do like these videos and share it amongst your friends and colleagues. There are plenty of other videos, and I hope you will be able to find time to browse through all these things. Thank you.